Good morning, good morning, good morning. What's going on, guys? Welcome to the lab. You know, I always come in a couple of minutes early, give everyone time to join in, give a couple of people time to get in, get up. I know it's a holiday weekend. We're about to get out shopping and everything going on, but just wanted to just come at you this morning again, guys, from the lab with author Keith Childs. We'll be getting this thing kicked off in about a couple of minutes. Hey, what up, Jerry? Good morning, brother. Thanks for joining on. Love the support, man. Thanks for the support, Holmes. Hey, Deshaun McMillan. What's up, young lady? I'm going to need to call you because growing this team, I want you to be on my team with me in this journey. What's up, Ms. Porter? Thank y'all for joining in. Thank y'all for joining in. We're going to get started in a minute. You know, I always like to come on a little early, give people time to get on and get it rocking. Hey, what's up, my man? How you doing? Good, good, good. Stream partner. Brother Tony Lee. Hey, I'm going to have to get you, I'm going to call you after the show, twin. I need you on as a guest. So I'll be reaching out to you, twin. I definitely will. We got like one, two more minutes, guys, before we get started. Hey, Lyrics. Thanks for joining on. What up, Mr. Graham? Appreciate y'all. Thank y'all for coming on. We about to get this thing started in a couple of seconds. Get rocking. Thank you again for joining author Keith Childs and friends in the lab every Saturday morning at 11:30. We get this thing coming. We got a powerful packed broadcast for you today. Special guests come in for us to, guys, you know this is a village. This is why we created this, so we can all come together. It's not just about me. It's about all of us coming together to help each other in our goals. You know, as I always say, and I'm going to say it every day, every time I get on here, if you don't have a lane, we have to create one, and that's what we're doing. Some of us ain't fortunate enough to have friends and all that good people in the business that can kind of help us up. So we here learning from each other, growing with each other, and doing it. Okay, guys, let's get this started. Welcome, guys. Again, this is brought to you by Easy Pray, Empower Group Publishing. Guys, you see I'm plugging. That's what I do. Please check the book coming spring 2018. And as I always do, guys, I like to thank God first before we get started. Show great kickoff. So, guys, please, guys, I just wanted to say real quick, thank you, Lord, for us coming together, Lord, as a unit. All our individual talents coming together, learning from each other, and growing with each other. All right? Creating this village. Thank y'all, guys, for tuning in. Also, we got special guests coming on today, guys. A gentleman that coming on the show. He's absolutely great in the business. I met him not too long ago. Been seeing him around for years. Real good dude. Like him. Man, really like the guy. He's doing great things in the community, and he's going to tell you more about himself. 17 years in the business, guy. 17 years in the business, 14 years as an actor, and 3 years behind the camera. So he got tons and tons of stuff that we can learn from him. So he'd be with us today, guys, at 11:45 on a hot seat. A man other than Randall, independent filmmaker and actor, Randall Lawrence, will be with us, guys. So sit back. Get ready. Y'all know I got to bring this in with my music. You know, I got to have my theme music coming in. Now, this song that I chose today actually got twofold. One, because it's just the kind of person I am. I'm upbeat. I'm a glass half full kind of person. You know, negativity, guys. One thing you will learn, and you will probably, most of you already know, as you do stuff and grow, you will always see that you will have people tugging and pulling you back. Some of us call them haters, some call them crabs. But this song that I'm going to bring on, twofold, is one, to shake those crabs off and let's loose up and have fun, because I'm going to dance in the face of haters all day long. You know, haters are my elevators. You know, the longer you keep hating, the more. What's up, Gil? The more, you know, I just rise. So, but this song also, too, is played at my mom. My mom just passed away. My mom passed away last year. The 20th of December was her 1 year anniversary to her death or going home. So, but this song was played at a funeral, so it means a lot to me. But I'm gonna let it see a little bit going to it. What's up, Keisha Lee? And sit back, guys. You know, I always gotta start with my music, all right? So we'll be back in a second. Listen to this.
Look at somebody and tell them that Jesus.
better know it.
Come on, Lois, you know, think about the sunshine. Come on, move a little bit. I just want some young people out there to just come up here. We don't want y'all to go crazy, but come on, give us some.
Hey!
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Come on, where are young people?
Gil Nelson.
You made my day.
You gotta shake them off sometime, guys. Dance in the face of them haters. Because they gon' hate.
We love y'all.
You might as well give them something to hate.
You hate me every time I pray. You gave me peace. You gave me
rest. That's right. Thank you, didn't you? Come on. Thank
you.
You hear that? Hey, Pastor Tony Lee. I need you as my guest, brother. That's my man.
Alright. No matter what your problem, God can always solve them. God can always solve them.
Alright, guys, welcome to the show, guys. That's, you know, I like to bring it in like that. Welcome, guys. Thank y'all. Let me just say absolutely. Thank each and every last one of you all for joining on, for tuning in. This is a village, again, that we creating here. This broadcast is coming every Saturday morning, God willing, 11:30. We get it on here. So if you are an aspiring author, you're an aspiring artist, musically, behind the scene, behind the camera, in front of the camera, actor, actresses, whatever. This is what we want to do, guys. We want to make sure that we come together and we can learn from each other and we can pull from each other. And we bring guests on. I'm going to bring individuals on who's doing it much bigger than myself, who I'm learning from every day. So every guest that I have on here that we can learn something from on all across the spectrum. So this is for all of us. This is our thing. That's why it's called In the Lab with Author Keith Childs and Friends. So even if you're not a part of none of that, but you're just showing support, I love you. Thank you for that. Thank you for that. All right, guys, so we're going to get into this. So I always like to go over a couple points, and this is a real laid-back, family-oriented broadcast. So what I want to talk about today, a couple things, guys, is getting into this. Now, one, Easy Pray, the trilogy. Gaps and guys, you see, promoting, that's what I do. And we'll talk about that going down. But the first topic, what I want to go into today, guys, is putting your team together. How important it is to put your team together. And when you're doing this, because understand, and I'm giving to you firsthand, we may not have the money. You may not have the money to do the things you want to do. You may not have all the resources. That's why, God, I'm thankful that God made me the way it is, because I want to reach out. So it's resources right around us. This is just us putting stuff like this together to reach out and help each other. But this is one of the main reasons this is how I created this. But I'm saying putting your team together, because you cannot do this by yourself. Believe me, it's way too much to do. That's why when you sing or you do anything, you got managers, you got agents, you got booking agents. People serve a purpose, in your success. You're not successful by yourself. Nobody is successful by themselves. And if you think you are, you're misguided. So find people that really, really genuinely want to see you succeed and believe in your success and looking and want to be a part of your vision. And team up with them, and team up with them. That's all reach out to people, that's really honestly want to see you grow. There are some really, really a lot of good people out here that want to see you grow, and that way you help them grow as well. But that's putting your team together. Like for me, I got a lot of stuff that I do, a lot of stuff that I'm doing, especially just on the Easy Pray grind. I got a book coming out, in the spring. Been so blessed with people, man. I couldn't did this without so many people. I'll just be naming forever. I start naming people. But so many people with all the well wishes. So many people that's helping me guide. My editor. Let me tell you a quick story about my editor. A friend of mine who, when I told her I was writing a book, you know, again, this is my first book. I didn't know too much about what to do. But, you know, my guy Mitch Cradle, my man who was on last week, you know, they tell me stuff. Keith, you got to get your editor. I'm like, okay. You know, I can't edit myself. I can write. I'm, you know, just found out that I just got a talent in writing. So, anyway, the young lady, my friend, said, hey, there's an editor I want to introduce you to out in L.A. I'm like, okay. Talk to him, nevertheless. Send him my stuff. We, you know, we did the contract, everything. Send him my, I had no idea what editing costs, none of that. Went to a writing class. Found out that good editing would be between $2,500 on up to $10,000 or more. It all depends on the editor and what they worked on and what, you know. So I got it. Okay. So now I kind of got a feel for pricing. But the editor that I reached out to, she was explaining to me, Dr. Maxine, she explained to me different styles of editing and all this I'm learning. So I sent her my rough draft, my manuscript. I sent it to her. She got it, you know, telling me, you know, how to clean it up. And now, I was just moving so fast, I didn't take time out to stop and wonder about her credentials. So, you know, time went on. So she had my information. She had my book. I asked, I said, can you send me some stuff on you? Because I've just been moving so fast, so excited. I didn't even ask you what your credentials. Have you ever edited any books? Let me tell you something. How wonderful God worked. This lady who's editing my book have edited over 100 books. Over 20 bestsellers. New York bestsellers. She wrote 12 herself. She worked on 8 books for guys like Carl Weber, the young lady on Basketball Wives. I mean, her list is just incredible. She got 2 movies right now on Netflix. So it's just like, wow. Wow. And so now, you know, just go to show. See, the rawness of not knowing who she was and talking and laughing and joking with her and sending my stuff. So now, before I even knew that, God had it to work that way. I didn't know who she was because I didn't want to go into it. No preconception ideas of her or the person. So then now I'm like, whoa, okay, reading who she is. So she says to me, I've worked on a lot of bestsellers, Keith. You know, and I don't want to get, we don't want to get before ourselves, but you have a really, really, really good book. And I was like, I appreciate that, God. Thank you, I really do. I appreciate that. Now, I ain't saying out here that, hey, my book bestseller. Hope that it is. But I just felt good to know that somebody I got on my team have already been down that path many times before. I'm just kind of come down that door. So that's what I mean, guys. Get your team together. Work on your team. Start putting pieces in your publishing, your PR, your editor, all that stuff, because it's very important to the success of what you do. All right. Also, guys, second thing, guys, I want to say, stay focused on your project. Stay focused. Stay laser focused on your project. You know, you got to eat, drink, sleep it. You got to love it. You know, if you got that passion behind it, it'll happen. You know, write whenever, if you're a writer, write all the time. I always say this, write all the time. Write. Don't let no one knock you off your square. Don't let nobody come in and say, don't do it that way, don't do it that way. That's just my opinion. I know people probably say, nah, Keith, I shouldn't say that, but there are people that's way better writers than myself and know way more than me. I know that. But I think if you have a raw talent, just get your rawness out. Write what you have and then work with people to try to mold what you have. Because if you go in there too early, you can get so confused and convoluted with all of the, oh, don't do it this way. Write it this way. Write it in the third person. Write it. You may kind of get frustrated and shut down. So, guys, just keep your craft raw and get around people. And like I say, and just make sure you stay laser focused on your project. All right? Also, too, guys, the whole piece about just marketing. As you ought to know me and understand, I'm marketing. Hats, I'm going to have a flyer here. Flyers, if you're my friend, you're probably going to see it on my page all the time. You're going to see it even more. I'm out anywhere passing out these flyers. This is my book cover, guys, on the wonderful t-shirt that I got, guys. And these t-shirts are coming. I have different t-shirts, hats. This is what you do. You want to promote yourself, guys. What my mindset, when I start thinking about the marketing, as my slogan is, hit the ant with the sludge hammer. You never could do too much marketing. Overkill it. That just means overkill it. Hit the ant with the sludge hammer. You got to do it because people really need to see stuff 7 times before they even realize it, you know? So you got something you're doing and it could be wonderful and great, get out of your comfort zone. Get out there, reach people, talk to people. Tell them what you're doing. Hey, how you doing? I'm a new author, I'm a new writer, whatever. Please, support me. That's it. Even the ears or the hands, but at least you're doing it. You can't get out there. You can't let people know, I mean, not know what you're doing. And then you're sitting back wondering why you ain't getting no love on your book. You're not talking about it. You know, you're not going out reaching people. So do that. Reach people. Because people reach people. When people like you and people like your stuff, they'll tell it and let that and that grassroots grow. All right? But again, guys, let me give a shout-out real quick. This T-shirt, guys, is from one of my school, high school friends who has a wonderful business named Sabrina Hamilton, guys. DMV Silk Screen and Embroidery. High school friends, guys, look her up on Sabrina Hamilton. She does silk screen and embroidery. She did this. You know, so I'm going to have... So this is what I'm talking about, that village. See, all these people... a part of my team. All these people part of my team that we want to help. To, you know, if you got a talent, you do stuff. I don't care. Whatever you're doing, let me know. I'm going to promote. I'm going to push it because we're going to win. We're going to win. Again, we here in the DMV, and this is for anybody that's not in the DMV, but here, let's push. Other places do it. There's no reason why we shouldn't. Y'all see me keep looking at the time because we're getting close to my, you know, this show's a real short little, nice little broadcast, and I know I go, try to go, not try to cover too much because I don't want to I don't want to, if you're thirsty, and I don't want to turn a fire hydrant on and give you too much information. I try to give you a little bit of points each Saturday, and we could talk about, all right, and I'm about to bring up the special guests in a couple of minutes, so, and let them, you know, tell you about themselves and what they're doing to be inspired like I am by each and every last one of them, and I have a power-packed guest list that's coming. People calling me, and it's getting really, really good. I'm reaching out to people, and, you know, hopefully to bring each and every last one of you all some good information about how we get our craft off the ground, how we grow this. Because you can bet, you know, I'm one, I'll work with you, I'll promote you, you know, I'll big you up. I'm happy about whatever you do, because what's for you is for you. You know what I'm saying? What's for me, God already got for me. What God got for you is for you. So I'm happy for you doing that. And absolutely, absolutely will. All right. So let me look on here, guys. You know, we got to do this. I'm looking for my man, Lawrence. Lawrence, if you tuned in, let me see where you on here. If my man, Lawrence Randall. Randall Lawrence. Got his name backwards. My man, Randall Lawrence. I'm being professional. Call his name backwards. All right. Let me see. Randall, are you on? If he's not on, let me check and see. If he's on... I'm going to bring him in. Not all. Wait till he tune in and get on. I don't see him on yet. But, Randall, I'm waiting for you to come on, brother. So, but like I was saying, guys, our special guest, guys, he's an independent filmmaker, actor, 17 years in the business, 14 years acting. Wow, it's great. 3 years behind the camera. He's doing this thing. Hey, what's up, Randall? I see you on now, but you got to push your camera so I can bring you on as a guest. Push your camera around so I can get you on, guys. I see that you say you're here. You know, we didn't work. We're going to work this together. We family. So just get it. Work it. I had the same thing. We had the same thing going on with my man Mitch last week. But we had to go ahead and figure this out. I see that you're here, Randall. I think on your end, you have to push the camera or something. So make sure that I see you, because the add button got to come on my end. And if anyone out there know how to, can tell him what he need to do to come on, please let him know what he need to do on his side so he can join on. Because I see you, Randall. I see that you in, but I don't see where I can add you on yet. But I'll keep moving, guys, until he get that straightened. He'll get it done. So, guys, again, just remember, stay on. You're building your team. Get your team built. You know, start working on it. I don't care if it's you and one person. That one person can grow to two people. That two people can grow to four people. So you just keep on working with your team. Get people around you. Y'all on the same mindset. And you work it. Because it's extremely hard. Extremely difficult to do it all by yourself. And then sometimes we feel like we have to. You know, we don't have individuals we can go to get capital from. We don't have no one that want to help us pass out this, and nobody want to help us build this. I get it. You know, so you got to sometimes do everything on your own. But there are people out there that will definitely help you do it. Randall, can you get on, Rand? I don't know, but hopefully I'll be able to get my man Rand on. I'm really looking forward to hearing from him. Let me see something here. Is there anything that I need to do? All right, let me see. Randall, and I just sent you, Randall, an invite. Let me see. If you catch, you see the invite on your side?
I got him.
There we go. All right, guys, let me bring you up right, man. Guys, thank you. Hey, we're going to work this out. We good here. Guys, let me bring up
my man.
Oh, no problem. Hey, we're going to work this out, homie. We're going to get this. That's why this is what we do. And once one day we're going to have this thing so tight. it's my pleasure to bring up my man, independent filmmaker, actor, 17 years in the business, 14 years acting, 3 years behind the camera. Brand, I have a ton of questions waiting for you. So please, guys, let me just bring you up. First question I'd like to drop everyone at the house, see, Rand, is please tell the people about yourself and how'd you get started?
Oh, that's cool. Good to be here, Keith. Thanks for having me. Come on.
Oh, you're absolutely welcome.
I've been in the business for about, I want to say 17 years now. I first started I didn't start on the independent side. I started with on the production side of actual films. Like, I started off with the TV show The Wire. I moved on to a couple of big-name independent movies. So it wasn't like me starting on the independent side. I truly started on the production side as an actor.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I want to say it's been almost 16 to 17 years, maybe 14 to 15 in front of the camera, and probably about maybe 3 behind the camera. Like I said before, I started off as doing extra work with a couple of production companies, and then I moved on and did a couple of things with The Wire, did a couple of things on the movie Jamesy Boy, a couple of other movies, Rocky IV. Worked with a whole lot of other people in the business. A couple of major things, but what I wanted to do was take control of my own destination. So, what I did, I started a production company called All Lines Films, and that was about 3 or 4 years ago, and that's what I've been doing ever since.
That's absolutely, man. You know, I got tons of questions. I'm ready to rock.
Yeah, go ahead.
So, hey, first of all, that's what's up, man. Just to see. One of the powerful things I love about this is we got cats that's in our own neighborhood, our own, that we can touch, that's been on major stuff. You know, your information helps cats like me and new cats that's coming up, that's inspiring, because we don't know, we don't live in Hollywood. We can't just turn, just turn and touch people who understand it. So question is, one of the things is I want to ask is, which one do you find, I don't want to say difficult, easier, behind the camera or in front of the camera? Which one do you enjoy the most?
I got a love for both of them. I don't know. I don't think that there's a which one I love the most. I got a love for both of them. I love being around people who inspire me to do better. That's what I love, whether it's behind the camera or whether it's in front of the camera. So I got a love for both. I don't have a favorite yet.
Right.
I got a love for both. I think acting will always be my love, but I truly have a love for being behind the camera too as well.
Right, to take your vision. I know with me, like right now, I'm with this book I'm doing here, and I've been talking to some more people now about to do a production, and then hopefully one day become a movie, and I'm getting all the stuff. But and you definitely can speak to this, when you have an idea that now, from a impregnation stage, and you see it form and manifest to something real live, I mean, it's a whole new feeling. From ideas you came up with, now you see people.
Oh,
going.
Man, I'll tell you. I think I was speaking on this probably about a week ago. When I write scripts, it's just a blueprint for you to, as an actor, for you to go ahead and manifest that character and make it your own. I love that process. I love giving opportunity to people who love the craft. So me providing the script and the actor bringing it to life is a wonderful feeling to me. Just to have an opportunity for somebody to bring something to life that I created or that we created is a wonderful feeling. It's a wonderful
feeling. Okay. Hey, appreciate that. All right, guys, before we get all the way down, I gotta ask one of my signature questions. I'm gonna ask if there's anyone in the business that you can work with, who would you like to work with? You had a chance to work with anybody in the business?
Sidney Poitier.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Wow. Major.
Yeah.
Major.
Sidney Poitier.
Sidney Poitier?
Sidney Poitier. Cool. Most people fail to realize Bill Cosby and Sidney Poitier mm-hmm. laid the foundation down for independent filmmakers such as the ones that we had right now. Lee Daniels and all the other rest of the black. Because back then, they were doing stuff that was unheard of. They was producing their own thing because other people, other big production companies wouldn't give a black person money, finances to finance a black right. movie. You know what I mean? So now they laid mm-hmm. they laid payment down for it. So, and not only that, they were just superb actors. So if anybody wow. I wanted to work with, it'll probably be Sidney Poitier.
That's a great choice, man. Sidney Poitier. Well, man. Well, hey, Rand, appreciate you hopping in, but, you know, I got to ask this for you. Please, a couple of things. Let everyone out there know in 2018 what you have coming up. Let them know everything you're doing. And when closing, please let them know how they can contact you.
Right now, we're in the production and working with, we're doing a movie called Water with a Slice of Lemon. It's written, produced by me, but we have a phenomenal class of people that's helping us. We have Scott Midget. He's actually doing the photography and videography. We got Kareem Mobok. I don't know if people I know a lot of people are familiar with him. He's come aboard. We got a lot of phenomenal actors. Donnell Dupree, Gil Nelson, myself, Cross Thompson. A lot of unknown, phenomenal, independent actors working on this project. And we hopefully we'll have it out by early 2018. But yeah, it's an independent film called Water with a Slice of Lemon. It's kind of sort of like that Ocean's 12, Ocean's 11 film. I wanted to do something a little bit different.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
That's what we got working on. And right after that, we're doing Second Chance Redemption. This is a spinoff from Second Chance, the first independent movie we did. And then we're doing another one called Rudolph. We also helping Gil Nelson with his project. We got a couple of things lined up right after this. A couple of things.
Well, good. Yeah. Appreciate that, brother. Let people know, Randall, man. Definitely, one, let people know how they can contact you if they were interested in being an actor, actress, or just want to cast for your show, anything.
We hold auditions. The casting information is Black Carpet Productions for this movie, Water with a Slice and Lemon. It's Black Carpet Productions. You can get at me through Facebook or Instagram. It's the name. All you have to do is really type the name and it'll pop up. That's basically it. And Twitter, all you have to do is type the name and it'll actually pop up. What information, I think for me telling people to actually want to get into the business is, what I have to say is, you truly have to do your research and study your craft. I want to be an actor. I want to be an independent filmmaker. And you hop up and you grab a camera, or you hop up and you jump in front of the camera. And, you know, just try to pretend. That's not how it works. The more and more you study your craft, the better and better you'll get. The more and more you surround yourself with people who know the craft, the better and better you'll get. Like I said before, I came from high-end production. I worked with Kevin Spacey, Jodie Foster. I mean, I worked with a ton of people. So I didn't come in through the independent level. I came in on a true high end professional level. Not saying that I'm of that caliber. No, that's not what I'm saying. But what I am saying is the lessons that I was taught, it was taught by people that were already there. What I did was strive that information and brought it to myself and brought it to my company. So it's like an each one teach one thing where we are. It's like we doing more learning than we are learning and having fun. But I think every single day that we film, it's like us going to school as well, because we truly want to understand this craft and want to take it to the next level. So, I can truly say is, don't just think that you're mm-hmm. just going to jump into it. It's not that type of party. What you need to do is just study your craft and get better. Don't worry about that.
And that's just,
if you're in it for the financial benefits of it, then you got the wrong right. mentality, because it don't work like that.
Right.
Yeah, it does not work like that. Yeah, it don't work like that.
Well, Randall, that's just what, and I'm glad that segued perfectly to what I wanted to say, is people like yourself who've been in the game, who understand the game, there's a lot of people who, and I don't want to discredit anyone, talent, anything, that's mm-hmm. not what the show is about, but I want to just bring light to, like yourself, Mitch Cradle, these cats, and everyone I speak to Even like my one of my guests that's coming on, your actor, he's on my list. He's on the schedule. Gil Nelson. He's gonna be in the hot seat in the new year. But it's about training. Everybody says the same thing. The common denominator is you must train. Yeah. You must, because a lot of people feel like they can get in front of that act. They feel like they can get in front of that camera and it's easy.
They can't. You can't. It's a whole different monster, man. It's a whole different monster. Right. Just because you see somebody else do it with ease, it's a lot of things that go behind that. I'll tell you, you talk that junk all you want to. Once you get in front of those big cameras and once you get in front of those lights, it's a whole different ball game. A whole different, and especially once you get around somebody, another actor who knows exactly what they're doing, it's a whole different ball game. It's a whole different.
Right.
What I can recommend to anybody, do theater first. Because if you strive in theater and if you make it in theater, it'll be an easy transition for you to come into film. It'll be just that easy because theater, that's a whole different level. You have to know, you have to be consistent with your lines, consistent with everything that you're doing. It has to be consistent. Whereas the filming, we can stop and do rehearsals and stop in between and fix it. Theater, you can't do that. So once you've learned that craft of theater, you can transition that stuff into film. It'll be a walk through pop. It'll be a walk through the park.
Yeah. Great stuff there, man. That theater. So that's what I've heard that before, too, that people that actually go. That's why you see a lot of the big actors come from theater and come to the big screen, because maybe that's the whole transition that a lot of young actors need to study.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you see, they've been doing
it. Yeah, and if you don't have I'm gonna tell you, if you don't have a love for it, if you don't have a love for what you're doing, don't waste your time. Don't waste your time. Don't waste anybody's time. If you don't have a love for what you're doing, don't waste your time. You gotta love the craft so it can love back. You gotta love it. You gotta love it.
Absolutely.
Yep. You have to love it.
Definitely. Hey, Randall, that's our time on the hot seat, brother, in the lab with my man, Randall,
I appreciate filmmaker.
After, thank you so much, bro. Please come back.
Will do.
But absolutely, man. Good, great luck and good success, man, going into 2018, man. Appreciate you, brother. All right.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Have a good one.
Okay. Thank you. Guys, that was my man. Oh, man, he gave us so much information, guys, to flow on. If we keep trying to, everything is just, that was powerful. Randall, big ups, man. Big ups to Randall Lawrence. Much success in 2018 on all your projects, brother. Great, great, great stuff, man. You dropped so many nuggets right there. Hopefully when you listen into this show, you're writing down. If you're inspiring to be active, he just shared some information that's so prevalent that I didn't even think about. Guys, if you think about acting, get in a play. Start learning theater. Learn your craft, because you save time and money than just think you can get up and just act. They've never been in a play, never act, because it helped your craft. But that's the jewels. Please look back on this. Get the jewels, guys. Thank you, Randall, man. Appreciate it. Guys, that's the hot seat. That's the show. Let me just about close down. I got a plug. Definitely, guys. Easy Prey, as you see. Easy Prey, the trilogy. Easy Prey coming spring 2018. The novel, the hot trilogy, guys, coming out. Please support it. I need each and every last one of you to support it once it come. Please, guys, and hopefully we can take this book and it's all what it's built up to be. And and then we take it to the screen. If that's in God's will, we'll take it to the screen and we're gonna have fun with it. We're gonna grow this village. We're gonna move together. We're going to move this thing together. So if you're down with me, lock in. I'm down with you. Let's lock in and get this thing going, guys. But let me just say, I will reach out to Randall after the show, get his contact information for those who want to speak with him. As you see, he's been around some heavy names. He's been in the game. He's knowledgeable. If you're new in the game or you're old in the game, you can lean on him. I know I will be. So I will get his contact information. I'll have it on after the broadcast. I'll put it up so you can reach out to him. Okay, guys. Also, too, if you want to contact me, guys, my email is AuthorKeithChilds. Real easy. AuthorKeithChilds, guys, @Yahoo. It's AuthorKeithChilds @Yahoo.com. Really, really easy. You can follow me on Facebook as you're doing now. Eventually, what I'm going to start doing, guys, is taking this broadcast to YouTube as well, so we can grow the audience, and we're going to make this really, really happy. Let me give you some dates, as I often do, guys. Next Saturday, guys, I will be on the U-Style Magazine broadcast live with Miss Bridget Davis, guys. I think that will be it. I think it's 7. I don't know why I didn't write that down, but I'll, don't quote me on that, but I will have the time. I'll put it up. the time to be there. Bridget Davis, I'm excited about that. We host Bridget Davis. He have a wonderful hot show on You Style Magazine, and it's on. You would tune into that to listen radio, and I'll have the address and everything how you can log in on that. Also, too, on the 7th, I'll be on a China Pink show at 5 o'clock. So, guys, those things, and I'm lining up each week or as much as I can speak to people to get onto their show so we can talk about this book. I'm going to talk about Easy Prey. You're going to fall in love with Mallory Bell, or you're going to love her or hate her, but we're going to get in there and we're going to push this, guys, and make this thing happy. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you for all of your support. Keep that going out. Also, too, let me throw out some names, guys, because the list is the lab. Hot seat is filling up. Next week, we're looking at, I think, have my man Anthony Commodore. I got to confirm with him. We talked. We have him on. But next month, guys, I got my girl Jeannie Jones out in L.A. doing it big in the industry. She will be on, as well as you heard, actor and playwright, my man Gil Nelson will be on. Producer Sky, my man out of Philly, be doing some good stuff. My man Sky is coming on. Producer Kenya Summers, who's a good friend of mine and on our team, man, at the Empower Group, man, we met, and she's a jewel. And I just got tons and tons of people, man, that I want to bring on and speak to, and new artists. And I just spoke out to my man, to Pastor, to one of my good friends I'm super proud of, man, Pastor Tony Lee. You know, we grew up together in the same neighborhood, and I just love his spirit and how he, you know, what he's doing and the love he had for his family and kids. I'm going to speak, so I'm going to have people on, guys, just blessing us. This is about us blessing, we ain't hating, we having fun, we just loving on each other, and we growing. All right, guys, so, you know, I'd like to give my quote of the day before I check out, and I love this quote here. Guys, I love this quote. As I look back on my life, I realize that every time I thought I was being rejected from something good, I was actually being redirected to something better. Let me say that again. As I look back on my life and realize that every time I thought I was being rejected from something good, I was actually being redirected to something better. Don't quit. Whatever you're doing, whatever your drive is, whatever your goal is, whatever your dream is, don't ever quit on it. Keep doing what you're doing. God got you. God got us. All right? Shake the haters off. Have a wonderful holiday. My music take me out because it's a perfect segue. Just keeping them haters hating and just love on yourself, guys. And have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year and all that good stuff, guys. Until next Saturday, I'm out. Thanks for joining the lab. Support Easy Prey when it comes, please. One. What's going on, Tracy K? Thanks, Sabrina. Hey, Karen. What up, Harvey? Hey, Felicia. Miss Cradle. My man, you know it. We gonna do this, man. We got this. As long as we got God, we can't miss. We got the best thing. Great show, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's brought to you by Empower Group, Easy Prey to Trilogy. Coming spring 2018. Support. Love you. Have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful holiday. I love y'all. Thank you for supporting me. Can take off. Can't let that go.